The sun breaks through and see you there beside me. I wanna reach out at night and pull you close. I wanna know your arms around me. I wanna dream your dreams, wanna make them all come true. Dance every dance you want to. Every breath I breathe will be for you.
Seated. This is a different wedding ceremony for me, and I'm going to take some liberty that I don't usually take. On behalf of my family and Amber's family, We welcome all of you here for this celebration. We're thankful for these two coming together, the love that our families have for each of them. We're thankful for their time together thus far and the expectation of time throughout their life until it comes to an end of one of them. I'm thankful for them not only as people that are recognized and thought of as family and friends, but as a brother and sister in Christ. I was present when Nick was saved as a young boy on an altar at North Gordonsville Missionary Baptist Church, and Amber has related to me her salvation experience at a camp in bed. I'm confident that that salvation experience that each of them has will serve them well in this marriage as they can go to the Heavenly Father and find their help and their strength in the times of need and the joy that comes with this union. I'm thankful that I know from their testimonies, and many of you that are here, I've heard your testimony, and that we have the expectation of a place in heaven together. And I trust that if there's those in our midst that don't know the Lord in the free pardon of sin, a real salvation experience that you can have with God and our Savior Jesus Christ, that you'll also find peace with Him through conviction of broken spirit and a contrite heart. And of all the things that they've gotten thus far in the anticipation of wedding, there would be nothing any greater that could happen than someone here find Jesus. And I trust that you'll search your hearts as we've come here for a solemn ceremony, but yet a joyous ceremony. Just a short while ago, and by short while, not long ago, once that they became engaged and we started talking about the ceremony, Nick had two requests. One, that we have it early enough in the year that it's not too hot. We didn't make that mark. The second was that it not take place during hunting season. And unfortunately, Nick is going to have to miss a frog-gigging tournament tonight over in Smith County, unless we get through early enough here for him to go. But that little bit of humor aside, as we approach this ceremony, Amber's desire was to have her grandfather walk her down the aisle. Unfortunately, he didn't make it. Nick just presented Amber with a handkerchief that belonged to him with an embroidered message on it. So he's here in one sense, and we're thankful for his memory. Without further ado, we'll begin. Dearly beloved, we're gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together Nicholas Sean Maggart and Amber Marnita Cockrell in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and His church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with His presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Just take your other hand and face me. Yeah. Nick and Amber, I require and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, before whom the secrets of all hearts are disclosed, that having duly considered the holy covenant you're about to make, you do now declare before this company your pledge of faith each to the other. Be well assured that if these solemn vows are kept unbroken, as God's word demands, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your heavenly Father, God will bless your marriage, will grant you fulfillment in it, and will establish your home in peace. Nick, will you have Amber to be your wedded wife, to live together in holy matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Amber, will you have Nick to be your wedded husband, to live together in holy matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself unto him so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Amber, would you pass your flowers to your maid? Face each other and hold hands. Nick, repeat after me. I, Nick. Take you, Amber.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do we part. According to God's holy ordinance. And thereto I pledge you my faith. Amber, repeat after me. I, Amber. Take you, Nick. To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do we part. According to God's holy ordinance. Thereto I pledge you my faith. May I have the bride's ring, please? The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of Nick and Amber in holy matrimony. Nick, will you take the ring, place it on Amber's left hand, third finger, hold it and repeat after me. In token and in pledge. Of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
With this ring I thee wed. May I have the groom's ring, please? Amber, will you take the ring, place it on Nick's left hand, third finger, hold it, and then repeat after me. In token and pledge. Of our constant faith. And abiding love. With this ring I thee wed. Hold hands. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, what a beautiful day that you've given us to have this opportunity to share in the uniting of this man and this woman together in holy matrimony. We're thankful for salvation. We're thankful for an assurity of heaven. We're thankful for those who have secured it by putting their trust in you. And we pray, our God, that you would pour your rich blessings upon this couple as they go forth in matrimony, that their home might be established in peace, and that as family comes, that they'll be blessed with healthy children, that they might be reared in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord. We pray, Lord, that you would bless those that duty binds to pray for the many people that are here to witness this event and to share in their joy, for those who could not come but have a heart's desire for here. We pray, Lord, that you would bless the families of both of these young people, that they might live in such a manner that there would be harmony and peace among them, that we could encourage both of them to live a godly life, to take up their cross and follow you, and together to be a great light to those around them. May they not allow friends or family to deter them from service to you, that they would stand up for that which is right and eschew that which is wrong. Lord, we ask your blessings on them as we go forward in this service. Do bless them. In Jesus' sweet and holy name we pray. Amen. For as much as Nick and Amber have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, in accordance to the laws of the state of Tennessee, and by the authority placed in me as an ordained minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. Amen. You can kiss your bride. Yeah. That little cowbell was on the car that Nick's grandmother and grandfather drove off in when they got married. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the first time my son-in-law, or my son and daughter-in-law, as Mr. and Mrs. Nick Maggart.
Me and my buddies grew up on a farm. Can't say much when you're working that hard. Just too tired to talk when the day is through. Never been much for writing love letters. A bunch of wildfires seem to say it much better. So if you're gonna ask me how I feel about me and you, yeah, we ride like a Cadillac, run like a deer. Girl, I ain't just whistling Dixie to tickle your ear. We're tied tighter than a rope in a double square. Said it. It took me a while, so don't you forget it. I've always heard, don't fix it if it ain't broke. So if you ain't doing nothing late around 11, come over, take a ride in my CJ7. I'll take you to places, honey, you ain't been before. Yeah, we ride like a Cadillac, run like a deer. Girl, I ain't just whistling Dixie.
Don't think so. Not a love this true. Common destiny, we were meant to be, me and you. Like a perfect scene from a movie screen, we're a dream come true. Suited perfectly for eternity, me and you. Every day, I need you even more, and the night time too. There's no way I could ever let you go, even if I wanted to. Every day stars above that we share this love.